Hello again to our global audience. Thank you so much for tuning in. This will be an analysis of Hezbollah's involvement, the Lebanese Hezbollah's involvement in the imposed war on Syria that has been going on since 2011. And not too long ago, I gave an interview to TRT World regarding this issue. It was a so-called debate. It was interesting. Usually debates are either one-on-one or two-on-two. In this case, it was 3-on-1, which was quite interesting, I found. Thank you for giving me that motivation, TRT World, to be even more stern when it comes to my analysis. At any rate, they were interested in exploring this issue. We know more than 10,000 Hezbollah soldiers have been involved in the war that has been imposed on Syria. There are estimates that, 4,000 of them have died in Syria. Of course, this could not be verified. These are all speculations, but that's the number that's out there. I don't necessarily find it useful in repeating that number because, we don't have any scientific facts to back that up. It's just estimates. At any rate, we got to go back a little bit in time here. In 2006, the Israeli war on Lebanon. In that war, Hezbollah fired 4,000 rockets against Israel. 11 years later, which is now, Hezbollah has increased its rockets stockpile to around 15,000. But the numbers, again, could be much higher. The estimates are anywhere from 15,000 to as much as 50,000. When you have this much variety in numbers, then you begin to doubt the whole thing. But the safe number, I would say, would be around 15,000 rockets. Hezbollah itself, we have to mention this, is not just a political party or a resistance movement, but it's a combination of both of those. They have a political wing, a military wing, and an economic wing, believe it or not. Hezbollah has built a very respectable place in South Lebanon. This is not an opinion, this is a fact. The movement runs hospitals, clinics, schools, as well as agricultural centers which provide consultancy to farmers with technical assistance and even training. This is very important to mention these things because most people don't understand that. The media is very, very biased against Syria and they don't give out exact functions of this resistance slash political movement. At any rate, hostility to Israel is the party's the Hezbollah. Let's just call it the movement, not the party. Is the movement's platform, especially since May 2000, when the last remnants of Israeli troops left Lebanon because of the success of Hezbollah soldiers. Keep in mind that Israel did invade Lebanon in the 80s. And again, it took you put the math together, early 2000s, they were there for close to 20 years. And had it not been for the formation of Hezbollah, probably the entire land mass of Lebanon would be a vassal state for the Israelis. So that it was because of their success that they kicked out the Zionist soldiers. It's a fact. This is something that TRT, the two guests, these two Wahhabi apologists that they had, were arguing with me. This is a fact, okay, that most of the Arab and Muslim world sees Hezbollah as a respectable resistance and social movement, more powerful than the Lebanese government itself. You have to go back to polls that were taken by Pew and by, what's the other one here? Gallup, okay? These are not exactly polls that would be sympathetic to the Hezbollah cause, and that was confirmed through them. How do we combine Hezbollah's activities and raison d'etre to what's happening in Syria? The Assad government, the Bashar al-Assad government, had a very long history, both the father as well as the son. Bashar al-Assad's father, who was Hafez al-Assad, the other president. The Assad government had a very long history of relationship with the Shia community in Lebanon. The leaders of the Amal movement, Imam Musa Sadr, to single out here, gave a fatwa in 1974 which for the first time recognized the Alawites as real Shias. And since the Israeli imposed war on Lebanon in 1982, Syria has supported to develop a Shia military organization, which is now called Hezbollah. Hezbollah was an effort between Syria and Iran to create a militia in Lebanon to basically be able to ward off the Israeli attacks there, the Israeli occupation. And keep in mind, Israel attacked Lebanon in 1982 with the excuse that the Lebanese were hosting the Palestinian fighters. They always find some lousy excuse like that to conquer another country. And anyway, going back to Israel and Syria, Tel Aviv has been behind at least four military strikes that we know of against Syria, aimed at preventing weapons from being transferred from Damascus to Hezbollah. There's four of them that we can document as of now. Tel Aviv has publicly called for the toppling of the Syrian government. So any attack on Syria will invoke Hezbollah's retaliation against Israel. And this will make Israel's war in 2006 against Lebanon look like a minor squabble. So the situation is extremely tense and Hezbollah is not going anywhere. Going back to a minor neurolingual programming tactic that Western media periodically use, I have an objection when they refer to President Assad's government as a regime. This is a preferred term of the NATO imperialist and the Wahhabi hegemonic interventionist. It's not a regime, it's a government. It's a legitimate government for now. And to call Syria a dictatorship is a joke, because you look at all these Gulf countries like Bahrain, like Kuwait, like Saudi Arabia, like United Arab Emirates. These are the most brutal and fundamentalist Islamist Wahhabi regimes. At least in Syria, we have a secular Shia government, a secular Alawite government, if you want to be precise like that. What else do I want to talk about? At any rate, going back to Hezbollah has gained legitimacy and the universal respect of the entire world by the virtue of being the first and the only force to kick Israel's satanic rear end. Really? I mean, it's incredible. Look back to 2006, what happened there? Look back to all these other wars that Israel imposed, and yet Hezbollah came victorious. Now, I'm not sitting here, I'm not being an apologist or a supporter of Hezbollah. I'm just laying down the facts for you here. The truth is, dear viewers, is that Israel is trying to trigger another civil war in Lebanon, okay? Vis-a-vis Syria and the whole contrived geosectarianism. This is something that those two illiterate guests on that show on TRT World didn't understand. They didn't understand that this, as much as they want to trigger a geosectarian conflict across the Middle East, a Shia versus Sunni conflict, and we are not in denial here. There, for the past 1400 years, there have been many issues between the Shia and the Sunni community, just like there has been in Europe for the past 500 years between Catholic and Protestants. But in essence, this is not a Shia-Sunni conflict, or we don't want to characterize it as that. We don't want to repeat this lie, because in essence, this is a conflict between true Islam in both Sunniism and Shiaism versus this dark age, barbaric, misogynist, false Islam interpretation called Wahhabism, with its sister false interpretation arm, Salafism. It's very important that you guys go on and YouTube this. Google and find out what these two cults, and that's exactly what they are, cults, is all about. So we have to recognize these things. We can't just shove them under the table. We cannot let propagandists fuel geosectarianism. And every time I go in one of these shows, the minute they start bashing Iran, the minute they start bashing Shiaism, that's when you know these are exact operatives, media operatives of the Saudis. It is clear. Shia and Sunni have been living in these countries, in all Arab countries, including Iran, which is majority Shia, for 1400 years now. And for the past 500 years, since the dynasty, the Safavid dynasty of Iran, Shiaism became the official religion of Iran. So there's Shia minorities in all these countries, but these people who go on mainstream media and they or any media and they try to fuel geosectarianism, they either work for Washington or Riyadh. And ISIS, imminent defeat. ISIS was a total Wahhabi Zionist project. Their defeat is a testament that the Shias and the Sunnis are coming together to defeat this Wahhabi monsters in terms of, ISIS or IS or ISIL or Islamic State, whatever hell they're called. Another thing I want to mention, every time the media, BBC, for example, is notorious for going out of their way and calling ISIS Islamic State is an insult on over 1.5 billion Muslims. These savages don't represent Islam. So every time BBC intentionally takes a few seconds to call it Islamic State instead of Daesh or IS, which is the preferable term, or ISIS or ISIL, then that's more accurate. You're not insulting 1.5 billion Muslims. At any rate, these lunatics, these savages, these barbarians, time is coming to an end. Mosul, the second largest city in Iraq, is being taken away from them. And they're suffering substantial defeat in Syria, and God willing, they will be defeated after Ramadan once and for all. But they're not gonna go away. Just like Al Qaeda, they're gonna be sort of stashed away for now until the next conflict arises for these murderers to be used. At any rate, thank you once again for watching our analysis here. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't already. And let your hearts not be troubled. Even in times like this, let your hearts not be troubled. And as always, keep the faith. Thank you so much. And we look forward to our next broadcast. Thank you.